Once upon a time, there was a little ogre named Shrek, who lived with his parents in a bog by a tree. It was a pretty nasty place, but he loved it, because ogres like nasty. On his 7th birthday, the little ogre's parents sat him down to talk, just as all ogre parents have for hundreds of years before.
Listen, son, you're growing up so quickly. You're growing up bigger by the day.
Although we want you here, the rules are very clear.
Now you're seven,
so it's time to go away. Take some words of wisdom for your trip.
These are little things you need to know.
When you are grotesque, life is Kafkaesque.
Just keep walking,
and you'll find somewhere to go.
It's a big, bright, beautiful world with happiness all around. It's peaches and cream, and every dream comes true. But not for you. It's a big, bright, beautiful world with possibilities everywhere, and just around the bend, there's a friend or two, but not for you.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Watch out for men with pitchforks.
I know it's sad, very sad, but ogres are used to that. The hardships, the indignities. And so, the little ogre went along his way. Cue the happy villagers!
It's a big, bright, beautiful world. So come on and pray as we join the fun. We say it was fun, and we got a lot to do. It's a big, bright, beautiful world. And everybody sings kumbaya. We're playing the guitar as we barbecue.
Yes, this is my cue. Off you go, me laddie. And so, the little ogre found a perfectly rancid swamp, far away from civilization. So whenever a mob came to burn him at the stake, he knew exactly what to do. Keep your big, bright, beautiful world. I like it where I am, all alone. I got all I need, so read the stinking sign. Keep your big, bright, beautiful world. I like it where I am. Yeah, your big, bright, beautiful world is all teddy bears and unicorns. Take that fluffy barn and shelve it where the sun don't shine. I prefer a life like this. It's not that complicated. Sure, I'm fated to be lonely, and I'm destined to be hated. If you read the books, they say why I was created, but I don't care. 'Cause being liked, his girl's the overrated. Who needs a big, bright, beautiful world? I got my own little part of the world. It's not a big, bright, beautiful world. No!
don't mind the mud. You'll get used to it.
This place is a dump.
It isn't fit for pigs.
Hello? We can hear you.
We've
been
threatened.
Look,
there's
a pig. Look, you all read Lord Farquaad's decree.
Yeah, we read it. All fairy tale creatures have been banished from the kingdom of Duval. All fruitcakes and fruits will be sent to a settlement facility.
It smells like butt.
All right, when I call your name, step forward. Pinocchio the puppet.
Oh, I'm not a puppet. I'm a real boy.
That's your godmother over there. Fairy godmother.
You all need to go back where you came from.
Go back? We can't go back now.
Farquaad will turn us into breakfast.
The guy is bad news.
Hey, maybe you can talk into him.
Yeah, he listened to you. You're big and scary.
I'm also an ogre, which means I stay on my swamp and avoid large crowds. Or haven't you read the stories?
Oh, you mean the stories that say I'm a big bad wolf?
You don't even know me.
I always dreamed I'd get a happy ending. It was foretold
God, yes, I... Attention all fairy tale thieves. Your welcome is officially worn out. I'm going to this Farquaad guy right now to get you all back where you came from. I'll be right back.
Time to say vamoose.
So don't get comfortable.
Ogre on the loose.
And don't touch my...
Time to say goodbye.
Don't die.
Now this can't be right. I'm all turned around. Let's see. Took a right at the Candy Kingdom, past that weird old woman in the shoe. Took a left at Oprah's castle. Ah, what's this? Duloc, oh, good. Let's see. Oh, that's not very nice. It's just a donkey.
Step aside, Ogre. Let us at him.
Why? What did he do?
He's a talking donkey, a freak of nature, as are you, you unsavory beast.
You're going the right way for a smacked bottom, you are.
By the authority of Lord Farquaad, I'm authorized to place you both under arrest.
Under arrest, eh? This is the part where you run away. And don't come back!
And I just say, that was incredible. Man, they were shipping over themselves to get away from you. And I like that.
Oh, that's great. Why don't you go celebrate your narrow escape with your friends?
But I don't have any friends.
Now there's a shocker.
Say, you lost or something.
No, I'm just trying to figure out the best route to Duloc.
Oh, Duloc. I know Duloc. Man, you gotta let me show you the way because I am like a GPS with fur.
I'll be fine on my own. Thanks.
Oh, but nobody's fine on their own. Not when you look like we do. Hey, did you hear what they said? Man, this place is going stepford. We haven't got no joint forces. Otherwise, they're gonna lock me up and I can't go back in the cage. I don't know if I mentioned it or not, but I did 6 years in solitary for impersonating a piñata. Whoa, that was really scary. And if you don't mind me saying, if that don't work, oh man, your breath will certainly get the job done.
Listen, little donkey, look at me. What am I?
Really green?
No, I'm an ogre, you know. Grab your torch and pitchforks. Doesn't that bother you?
Nope.
Really?
Really, really.
Oh.
Man, I like you. What's your name?
Shrek.
Shrek, huh? Well, you know what I like about you, Shrek. You got the whole I don't care what anybody thinks of me thing. I like that, Shrek. I respect it. You are right.
Oh, good. Goodbye.
Hey, 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 you gotta let me go with you. You don't know what it's like to be considered a freak. Well, maybe you do, but that's why we gotta stick together.
Donkey, I told you.
No, no, don't speak, don't speak. Mm-mm. Just hear me out. I might surprise you. I'll be your friend when others despise you. Don't roll your eyes. Stop with the moping. You need a pal. My calendar's open. I'll bring you soup if you feel congested. I'll bail you out. If you get arrested, I got your back when things get scary. And then I'll shave it
when it gets hairy. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Oh, oh, oh. You need me. You need me. I'll treat you right. Never act shoddy. If you kill a man, I'll hide the body. So what do you say? You're not responding. I think we're bonding. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Oh, oh, oh. You need me. You and me, we belong together. Like butter and grits, like kibbles and bits, like yin and yang, stem and drang, like ing and chang, attack at the hip. But I don't know, lady, hip that might break. I'm gonna be on you like a bad kid on K. Yam, 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 yam. Like Cupid and Psyche, like Pop Rocks and Mikey. We'll stitch girl out that Velcro stuff. I'm the first to say, you'll be the spiky. Ooh, like little kids in pajamas with those funny things at the bottom. You know, and VDs and donuts. Oh, we go with donuts. Donuts and diabetes. You need me. You need me. I need you. 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 Don't let me go. Go. Don't let me go.
All right. Only because I'm lost, you can tag along.
Yeah,
only on one condition. You keep the chattering to a minimum.
Okay, you got it. No chattering. Man, you won't regret this.
I already do.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Shrek and Donkey, two stalwart friends, talking a real wind, big city adventure.
Bring in the cookie. Here you are, you and the rest of that fairy tale trash that's been poisoning my perfect kingdom.
It's not a kingdom, because you're not a king!
Oh, but I will be, just as soon as I find the perfect princess to marry. And I hear you know of one. Tell me where she is.
Eat me!
Now, I've tried to be fair to you creatures, but now my patience has reached its end. From whom?
Do you know the Muffin Man?
Yes. Yes, I know the Muffin Man who lives on Drury Lane.
Well, I heard it from the Muffin Man.
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man!
He heard it from the Muffin Man.
Can I go now?
You haven't told me where she is.
I can't.
You must.
I won't.
Tell me, or I'll...
No! Not the buttons! Not my gumdrop buttons!
Then where is the princess?
Okay, I'll tell you. She's a day's walk from here in a dragon guarded castle, surrounded by hot boiling lava!
Ooh, that sounds dangerous.
You want a princess or not?
Go on.
In the highest room, in the tallest tower, you'll find a fiery redhead named Princess Fiona.
Ooh, Princess Fiona. She sounds perfect, except for that dragon and lava thing. I'll have to find someone else to go.
Big surprise.
I shall make Fiona my queen, and Duloc will finally have the perfect kingdom. Captain, round up your men, summon the citizens, and bring that cookie to the swamp.
Swamp? That's the things I get?
Oh, and Captain, tell the royal coiffer I need to get my hair pressed. We're going to get a queen.
What kind of insane game is that?
Haven't you ever been on a road trip?
No.
Man, you need to get out more because, woo, punch buggy!
Ow!
I got you with the wagon full of hay over there.
Donkey, if you do that one more time.
Man, see, that's another reason why you need me around. Who else is going to fill you in on all the fun stuff you miss out on? You may not know it, but you don't want to look at...
3 o'clock.
Oh, Mother Hubbard, that hurt.
You know what? You're right. That was fun. Shall we play again?
No. That's fine. You win. Maybe we should move on to I Spy or have one on a picnic or something that's not going to put me in a batter case.
Hey, Donkey. Look. It's Duloc.
Ooh, didn't I tell you I found it?
It's a bit much, isn't it? You think he might be compensating for something? I'll forget it.
Special Princess Festival. Let the festival begin.
Hey, hey you. No, I'm not gonna eat you. I just wanna... This place is weird. Let's find this Farquaad guy so we can get out of here.
I want to stop by the gift shop to get a t-shirt.
No stopping for t-shirts.
Infested, freaks on every corner. I had them all arrested. Hey, naughty, 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 no. If you had a quirk, you didn't pass inspection. We all have our standards, but I will have perfection. And so. Are looking up here in Duloc.
Duloc.
just take a look.
The things I'm cooking up here in Duloc. A model that amazes, a plan with seven phases. Things are looking up here in Duloc. In Duloc. The ladies all look swell. The men are so dashing. Oh. Thanks to my new dress code,
the fashion's never clashing.
Hey, naughty, 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 no. This castle I have built on is taller than the cliff tops. A city like a postcard of monorails and gift shops. And so,
and so,
and so, and so. No one from the gutter in Duloc. Embrace the cookie cutter in Duloc.
We're all the same.
The upshot is enormous when you can shout.
Performance!
Yes! Things are looking up here in Duloc. Hey, let's give it up for the Duloc dancers. Aren't they terrific? You've all been waiting for the raffle drawing to determine who will have the honor of setting forth to rescue the lovely Princess Fiona from the fiery keep of the dragon. Spin the barrel.
Excuse me. Roar. Are you Lord Farquaad?
Maybe. Does the name strike fear in your heart?
No, but that little hat does.
Who let this thing in here?
Look, I'll be out of your silky little hair as soon as you give me my swamp back.
Your swamp?
Yes, my swamp, where you dumped all those fairy tale creatures.
Newsflash, ogre. That oozing mud pit is actually within the province of Duloc, which is therefore under my jurisdiction.
Now look here, half-pipe.
Wait a minute. Wait. Mianetto, this is too perfect.
What is?
You're big and hulking and perfectly expendable. People of Duloc, we have a winner! Oh, congratulations, ogre. You've won the honor of setting forth on a great and noble quest.
But we're already on a quest.
So get my swamp back.
Yes, and you've nearly accomplished it. All you need to do is one more simple little task, and I'll hand over the deed to your swamp.
And what is this little task?
The dossier on Her Royal Highness.
Things are looking up here in Duloc, here in Duloc, and no one's gonna bring me down.
Well, that was odd.
Not as odd as you agreeing to go on this quest. What do you know about rescuing a princess?
Oh, I've read the stories.
And I've read the sports pages. That don't make me a hockey player, do?
Oh, Dragon Tower, how hard can it be?
Oh, I bet we're going to find out. I'll tell you that. What's to say about the princess anyway?
Apparently, she likes pina coladas and getting caught in the rain.
Oh, she sounds fun. What else?
It says she's been locked in a tower since she was 7 years old.
Oh, that's sad. All alone since she was 7 years old, 7 years old, 7 years old.
You are so weird.
Here's a good one. It's a classic. There's a princess in a coma. Glad it's her instead of me. Pretty maiden in a glass box. How I wonder, does she pee? Blah, 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 blah. Poison apple. Boring, boring, evil queen. Clear filler in there red. That's seven shorties on the scene. Skip ahead, skip ahead. In the end, the princess wakes up with a start. The prince is good at kissing and melting Snow White's heart. So I know he'll appear and his armor will be blinding, as shining as his perfect teeth. And manly hose, he'll propose on one knee, and our prenup will be binding. About time we set a wedding date. Day number 958. I know it's today. He'll show up today.
There's a princess, any princess. Take your pick, they're all like me. Not exactly, I'm still waiting. They're out living happily. Ever after, better get here. I want love in seconds flat. No one needs these middle bits. Whoops, did I do that? Cut the villains, cut the vamping, cut this fairy tale. Cut the peril and the pitfalls, cut the puppet and the whale. Cut the monsters, cut the curses, keep the intro, cut the verses. And the waiting, the waiting, the waiting, the waiting. I seem a bit bipolar, and I'm a vandal now as well. Hope he won't mind. I'm a find, I'm a catch, and a very gifted bowler. It won't be my guarantee. Day number, are you there, God? It's me, Fiona. It's me, Fiona. Now I know he'll appear, 'cause there are rules and there are strictures. I believe the storybooks I read by candlelight. My white knight, my knight and his steed will look just like these pictures.
Shrek, why didn't you just make Farquaad give you your swamp back? You know, put some of that ogre stuff on him.
Throttle him, lay siege to his fortress. The whole ogre trip.
For your information, there are a lot more to ogres than people think.
Example.
Ah, onions. Ogres are like onions.
They stink?
No.
They make you cry?
Ooh. No.
Oh, you leave them out in the sun and they start getting all brown and start sprouting little white hairs.
No. Layers. Onions have layers. Ogres have layers. Onions have... Oh, you get it? We both have layers.
Oh, you both have layers. You know, not everybody likes onions.
Parfaits. Everyone likes parfaits. And they have layers. Like, have you ever met a person and you be like, hey, let's go and get some parfaits. And they say, heck no, I don't like no parfaits. Parfaits are delicious.
I don't care. Ogres are not like parfaits.
Ooh, parfaits may be the most delicious things on the whole darn planet.
You know, this may turn into the longest day of my entire life.
Ooh, I got the perfect remedy for that.
Donkey, please, I'm begging you.
Sing a song, yes, a travel song, when you gotta go somewhere, 'cause the fun is getting there. Yeah! Oh, what the heck, I must confess, I love a road trip. Sing a song, hit the trail, forget the maps, forget the guides. Before you know it, you may stride with me. And I know all I need all along, there's a path and a pal and a song, so I'm singing and I'm palling with you. See, makes the time go by fast.
Why me? Why me?
This is nice.
Tell me, what was my crime?
We are strolling.
As chatty as a parrot, more annoying than a mime.
Hey, look, a guy who's wearing boots. That's crazy!
Why me? Why me? A simple answer would be fine.
This is good cardio.
Won't someone please send me a sign?
Hey, look, a sign. You need a Pal Avenue straight ahead.
What did I do to deserve this, honestly? This ass of mine is asinine. Why me?
Oh, you see the little bunny?
Aye, he looks delicious. Oh, what now?
Oh, I just got to look. He might be compensated for some joke. Can be better than this.
Why
sing
me
a song?
Why me?
The road
a simple answer
is the way to get around.
Whoa,
before you know it,
you
gang
round
with
me.
And I know all I need
to
along. There's a path and a pal and a song, so
this
I'm singing. Lo-dee-do, and
this
I'm having
a night. Why Why am I with you?
Ooh, you feel that warm breeze?
Aye.
It came up so suddenly.
That's because we're on a bridge.
I didn't even notice. What bridge is this?
The bridge to the Dragon's Keep.
Oh, the bridge to the Dragon's Keep. So that intensity I'm feeling under my hooves is...
That would be the Lake of Molten Lava.
Oh, the Lake of Molten... The Lake of Molten Lava!
Donkey!
Woo, we are gonna rig the bridge over a Lake of Molten Lava!
Donkey, you'll be fine. Just keep walking and don't look down.
Oh, I'm looking down, Shrek, I'm looking down!
Oh, for the love of Pete!
I am frozen with terror.
Donkey, just take a step.
I can't!
Look in my eyes! Grab my hat! Now walk.
Okay, but don't let me go. Don't let me go.
I won't let you go. I won't let you go.
What did I do to deserve you, my pal, evermore? We crossed the bridge together. What a beautiful metaphor. Why I'm singing me? And why I'm telling and why I'm traveling
me? With you. That'll do, Donkey. That'll do.
Somebody before you just crack one off. Oh, my mouth was open and everything.
Believe me, Donkey, if it were me, you'd be dead. It's brimstone.
Mm-hmm. You're right, brimstone. Don't be talking to no brimstone, huh? I know what I smell. It wasn't no brimstone, it ain't come from no other stone either.
This ought to come in handy. All right, now you stay here while I go find the princess.
Stay here, you mean by myself?
Would you rather come and slay the dragon?
No, wedding is fine. But have her back. Man, this place is creepy.
You don't know the half of it.
Ah! Woo! Huh.
Oh. Hey, it's a new guy. We haven't had a new guy in a couple of years.
Shrek, come back! There are people with beards. Oh, geez.
You don't want to wake her up. She gets really angry.
What are you talking about? Who are you people?
We are nuns. Can't arrest a prince just like you.
None of us made it, though.
We're in the Lechamans. Everyone else, she ain't generous.
She keeps us around because we sing backup.
What? I'm out of here.
That's the
oh, my God, oh, my God, oh, my God.
Drama shades and lock my doors, but still you come for what ain't yours. Like a hound dog on all fours, yeah, you sniff around and around and around. You're gonna stay, you're gonna stay, you're gonna stay, yeah, yeah. Ooh. Forever.
Ooh, forever seemed like a real long time. And I got a hair appointment.
Another night, another day.
Another day.
We all know you all the same.
All the same.
Foolish mind, you want that thing.
Ha!
Then you fly around. This time we called you from the beach. That pretty girl, that perfect peach. She is always out of reach.
No.
But I am around and around and around. You're gonna stay.
Oh, man, oh, geez. Man, that's so close. Watch my tail. Oh, you got some real boundary issues. You know that? Ooh.
You think I like this job? But glory's not baby.
Baby,
baby, sit up. No one wants to rescue me. So, yeah, I'm a little bigger. Oh, says no great beauty. No one ever, ever, ever.
First of all, I'm not a knight. I'm a donkey. And if you don't realize that by now, you need to get your ass checked. Secondly, I don't even like that princess. She ain't my type. Do you want to know why? I like a big, big girl. I like a big, big girl. Best for me, boys.
He likes a big, big girl. He likes a big, big girl.
And as for you, I think you're bluffing, stomping around, all huffing and puffing. Won't you love? Stop with the hating. Unchain your heart. He is out there waiting. Well, hope we learned something valuable today. And if you excuse me, I'll be on my way. What's wrong with you? You got something in your eye.
But he wants me.
Uh-huh.
No great beauty. But he wants me.
Well, I wouldn't talk about me.
No one ever, 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 ever won't take me. So you're gonna stay.
Me specifically.
Anyone up there? Oh, can't you toss down some hair or something? Man, I know I should have worn my cup. Oh, great, I got one of the snoozers. Wake up! Are you Princess Fiona?
I am, awaiting a knight so bold as to rescue me.
Oh, that's lovely. Now let's go.
But wait, Sir Knight. I have long awaited this day, and I would as first like to know as the name of my champion.
Shrek?
Sir Shrek, I pray you take this favor as a token of my gratitude.
Thanks. All right, so where's the door?
There is no door.
No door? Well, how do we get down?
Why, the same way you got up?
The same way I... Oh, come on, I just... All right, hop on.
Now hold us on, Sir Knight. Don't you want to savor this moment? It beeth our first meeting. It must be a wonderful and romantic scene.
Oh, geez, I'm like a crackpot magnet.
This is how a dream comes true. This is how I pictured you. Climbing in to rescue me. This was always meant to be.
Oh, that's all lovely, but we really need to go.
This is how the scene must go. You standing there, the like just so. Then you smile and gaze at me. Take my hand on bended knee. Bended knee. Bended knee.
Ow!
Sorry. And though we've only met, somehow I always knew it would look like this when dreams come true.
Dave, what are you doing?
I have to go save my ass.
Brave Sir Knight, slow down a bit. Shutting girls are delicate. I've longed for this my whole life long. Now you're doing it all wrong. Down a rope, a steed awaits. That's what every story states. Riding over rough terrain, past the dragon you have slain. You have slain. You have slain.
It's on my to-do list.
I don't give you no
donkey!
Dragon! Just relax and take a breath. Hope he doesn't burn to death. Never mind the protocol. He's your hero after all. Ta-la-la-la-la, what's past is past. Ta-la-la-la-la, I'm free at last. In the end, the princess always gets her man. Part I didn't know. Wait a minute, book. It's just like in the book. They're fighting over me, like it's meant to be. No more tower in the sky. Slay the dragon and goodbye. Oh my God, we're gonna die. I knew it would be today.
You did it. You're amazing. You're awesome. You're a little unorthodox, I'll admit. But thy deed is great, and thine heart is pure. I am eternally in your debt. And where would a brave knight be without his noble steed?
All right, I hope you heard that. She called me a noble steed. She think I'm a steed.
Well, Sir Shrek, the battle is won. You may remove your helmet.
No.
And why not?
I have helmet hair.
Please. I would just look upon the face of my rescuer.
Oh, no, you wouldn't, Ist.
But how will you kiss me?
Kiss you? That wasn't in the job description.
Maybe it's a prank.
No, it's destiny. A princess is rescued by her true love, and then they share true love's first kiss.
With Shrek? Hold on, wait a minute. You think Shrek your true love?
Look, princess, let's just say I'm not your type, okay?
Of course you are. You're my rescuer. Now take off your helmet.
Look, I really don't think that's
just
a good idea.
Just remove your helmet.
I said no.
Now!
All right. As you command, Your Highness.
You're an ogre.
Are you expecting Prince Charming?
Well, yes, actually. Oh, no. I'm supposed to be rescued by my true love. Not some ogre and his pet.
Well, so much for a noble steed.
You're not supposed to be an ogre.
Listen, princess. I was sent to rescue you by Lord Farquaad, okay? He's the one who wants to marry you.
Oh, then why didn't he come rescue me?
Good question. You can ask him that when we get there tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Oh my gosh, it's almost sunset. We need to make camp.
Make camp, but you just escaped.
Yes, and I found the whole ordeal quite exhausting. I need to rest immediately.
Oh, well, that's very unfortunate, because we're gonna keep going.
I need to find somewhere to camp right now!
Oh, all right. There's a cave right over there.
Shrek, there ain't no place for a princess.
No, no, it's perfect. Well, gentlemen, I bid thee good night.
Look at honey. You want me to read you a bedtime story? Because I will.
I said good night.
She seems nice.
By day, one way, by night, another. This shall be the norm until you find true love's first kiss and then take love's true form.
And this is what I realized. If we escape the dragon, then we can do anything. Man, I could be a steed, or I could work for the crusade circuit. I can even be one of those horses who pull a wagon full of beer. I need some pair of extensions on my ankles, but I can do it. Who would you want to be?
I wouldn't want to be anyone.
Just for fun, though, who would you pick?
Nobody.
Like if you had to.
Donkey.
Like if a guy had a sword at your throat and was like, hey, you can't be an ogre anymore. Pick something else. Then who would you pick?
I would pick that guy up and hurl him into a tree.
Man, you ain't no fun at all. Is this what it's gonna be like when we finish rescuing the princess? Us sitting around our swamp all day doing nothing?
Our swamp? Donkey, there is no us, there is no our. There's just me and my swamp. And the first thing I'm gonna do is build a 10-foot wall around my land when I get back.
You cut me, Shrek. You cut me real deep just now. What's your problem anyway? What do you have against the whole world?
My problem? I'm not the one with the problem, okay? It's the world. You saw how that princess reacted. It's always the same.
Oh, big, stupid, ugly ogre!
They judge me before they even know me. That's why I'm better off alone.
But you know what, Shrek? When I first met you, I didn't think you were just some big, stupid, ugly ogre.
Yeah, I know.
So that's really the one else you'd rather be?
I guess I'd be a hero. Sword and armor clashing, looking semi-dashing, a shield within my grip. Or else I'd be a Viking and live a life of daring while smelling like a herring upon a Viking ship. I'd sail away, I'd see the world, I'd reach the farthest reaches, I'd feel the wind, I taste the salt and sea, and maybe storm some beaches. That's who I'd be. That's who I'd be. Or I could be a poet and write a different story, one that tells of glory and wipes away the lies. Into the skies I'd throw it, the stars would do the telling, the moon would help with spelling, and night would dot the eyes. I'd write a verse, recite a joke, with wit and perfect timing. I'd share my heart, confess the things I yearn, and do it all while rhyming. But we all learn, but we all learn. An ogre always hides, an ogre's fate is known. An ogre always stays in the dark and all alone. So yes, I'd be a hero, and if my wish were granted, life would be enchanted, or so the stories say. Of course I'd be a hero, and I would scale a tower to save a hothouse flower and carry her away. But standing guard would be a beast, I'd somehow overwhelm it. I'd get the girl, I'd take a breath, and I'd remove my helmet. We stand and stare, we speak of love, we feel the stars ascending. We'd share a kiss, I'd find my destiny. I'd have a hero's ending, a perfect happy ending. That's how it would be. A big, bright, beautiful world, but not for me. Of course I'd be a hero, and I would scale a tower to save a hot house flower and carry her away.
The sun's so big, it hurts my eyes, but really, that's okay. A brand new day with things to do, so many plans to make. I've had 6 cups of coffee, so I'm really wide awake. I've always been a morning person, a morning girl. Hooray! Hooray! Cheep, 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 cheep! Today's my wedding day. I haven't met my husband yet, but I'm hopeful anyway. I'll wear a gown, we'll have a ball, and dance forevermore. He'll take me in his massive arms and spin me round the floor. I've always been a morning person, a morning girl.
Good morning, Pied Piper.
Wow, what's so good about it? I can't get this stupid rest to follow me.
Well, I think you may need to change your tune, mister.
Thank you.
I'm sorbet. Last night I was a monster, but this morning, I'm okay. This morning, I'm okay. Why, good morning, men.
Morning.
Princess, did you happen to eat a few of those funny little mushrooms by the stream?
Of course not. I'm just happy that it's a new day, full of promise and fresh starts. And the first thing I'd like to do is apologize for my behavior yesterday. We obviously got off on the wrong foot, and I'd like to make it up to you.
You what?
Yes, so I've gathered a basket of berries for the trip, and I made you eat the daisy chain.
Well, look at these. Oh, they're just beautiful, princess. Oh, they beautiful. Ain't they beautiful, Shrek?
You'll grow to love them. I promise. Lead the way.
So, princess, do you often frolic with rats?
And what if I do?
Well, princess, germ-infested vermin, not exactly what I had in mind.
Well, maybe you shouldn't judge people before you get to know them. So, tell me about my groom-to-be, Lord Farquaad. What's he like?
Well, let me put it this way, princess. Men of Farquaad's stature are short in supply.
Really?
Oh, yeah, but he is a little intimidating.
Well, he must be.
And yet very good at small talk.
What is so funny?
Look, princess, I'm just saying you might want to lower your expectations a little bit.
Oh, yeah, like 3 feet or so.
All right, yuck it up. It doesn't bother me. Not today. After a lifetime of misery, things are finally going my way.
Lifetime of misery, okay.
You chuckled.
Hmm?
When I said lifetime of misery, you chuckled.
Did I?
Yes.
Look, I'm sure it was very hard living in that dragon guarded tower.
It was.
I'm sure.
All right then.
Although, it must have been nice having a roof and a cozy bed, which is more than I had when I left home.
You're not actually comparing yourself to what I endured.
I'm just saying, you don't corner the market on unhappy childhoods.
There are things you don't know, you know, about me, about how rough I had it.
What, you run out of shampoo a couple of times?
I mean about my life.
In that cushy tower of yours?
Cushy? Are you kidding? I had nothing in that tower, fighting boredom by the hour. Princess lonely, walking circles, I had only bare essentials, army cot, a hot plate, and a chamber pot. And every morning I would boil it. No choice, I had no toilet, just a view of devastation out one window. Isolation in my bedroom and very little headroom. 20 years I sat and waited. I'm very dedicated. On the walls the days were added. Luckily those walls were padded. So I think I got you beat. I think I got you.
Oh, you think so? Well, that's a sad story, but I've heard better. I'm just saying, A for effort, thanks for playing. Sad to see a princess suffer, but I had it rougher. Like that time a mob with torches burned my britches, see the scorches. You're just whiny. I had a flaming hiney. As I fled, I had to wonder if I were torn asunder. Would an ogre go to heaven? Did I mention I was seven? So, I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah, 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 I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat.
No more regards.
No Christmas cards.
And every day
was hell on Earth Day. My dad and mom sent me away. It was my birthday.
I was sent away on Christmas Eve.
Ah.
Very Santa's army got a hot plate and a chamber pot. And every morning I would boil it. No choice, I had no toilet. Just a view of devastation out my window, isolation in my bedroom.
My dad and mom sent me away.
On the walls, the days were added. Luckily, those walls were padded. 20 years.
I missed my prom. My dad and mom sent me away.
I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat.
Yeah.
I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat.
Yeah.
I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah.
Oopsie. Well. Better out than in, I always say.
Na 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 na.
Oh, na 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 na.
Princess Fiona, I am Lord Farquaad. No too formal. Fiona, hi, Farquaad. But you can call me Maximus, as I've no doubt you will. Woof. No too smutty. But soft, with light through yonder window breaks. It is Fiona, and Farquaad is the sun.
My lord, we just received word. The princess has been rescued. She's on her way.
On her way, she's on her way, and so am I. My adorable princess. I've always said I'd be king, and now look, the last adorable piece of my master plan. Oh, that reminds me, how are the wedding preparations coming?
We booked the cathedral and the band. But, my lord, I was wondering if you wanted me to invite your father.
My what?
Your father, my lord.
Do you mean that horrible little man who tried to keep me down my whole life? That vile grunt, that mal-tempered monster who abandoned me in the woods as a child.
Well, he had his reasons.
Lucky, please. My father simply couldn't accept the fact that I wanted nothing to do with the family business. That lowly, dirty family business. My daddy was a miner. He spent his whole life nearly underground. Then he met my mother, and he ran away with her. She could have been a queen, but she ran off with him. It was a bad choice. She's dead now. Oh, Daddy, you abandoned me in the woods as a child. Well, I climbed up and out. Oh, if you could only see me now, Daddy. I'd invite you to the wedding, but you'd have to be this tall to get in.
Sorry. Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Yoo-hoo, we're here.
What?
Would you look at that?
What is it?
It's Duloc.
Oh, Duloc. I didn't realize we were so close.
Ooh, congratulations, Princess. Your future awaits.
Yes, it does.
So much for that batch of Snuthers I was going to make us.
Snuthers?
Oh, they're traditional ogre campfire snacks. Sort of like s'mores, but instead of marshmallow and chocolate, we use squirrel gizzards and mulch. Oh, they just melt in your mouth.
Ooh, I think I need to sit down for a minute.
No time for sitting down. We have to get the princess to Duloc.
No! Look. I may not get another chance to try one of these Snuthers.
Princess. You eat one of them things, and you may not get a chance to do anything.
Zip it, donkey.
I was just thinking, maybe Duloc could wait until morning. I've spent my whole life without true love. What's one more night?
All right. I'll get us some dinner.
I'll get the firewood.
Okay. Do you want to just go together?
Sure.
Be going on around here. I've been watching in the centers of clear. A nervous laugh when she brushes his skin. The sweaty palms, the big dopey grin. With the giggle and the flip of her hair, I smell the pheromones in the air. Making Google eyes over the food. They need my help here and set in the mood. Oh, you don't believe love is blind? Well, I got some friends who think otherwise. And here they are, direct from my imagination. Watch your step, girl. You gotta turn up the heat, you gotta butter the pan, you gotta make a move and don't be afraid. Reach for a hand, maybe give her a kiss. She's waiting for a move to be made. You got to, got to, got to. You gotta make a move. You gotta make a move. You gotta make a move. Yeah!
These others are so good.
Didn't I tell ya? And a little nutty, right?
Mm-hmm. I guess I'll be dining a little differently tomorrow night.
Well, you can always come and visit me in my swamp. I can fix all sorts of things for you. Fish eye, tartare, swamp toad soup, you name it.
I'd like that.
Shrek. I know you can hear me right now. I am in your corner, buddy, but you have got to tell this girl what you really feel deep down. You better get another chance. So just go on.
Princess.
Here we go.
Yes, Shrek?
Oh, he's going to tell her.
I was wondering.
Oh, I can't take this.
I was wondering.
Okay.
I was
gonna. Spit it out!
Are you gonna eat that?
Man, what is wrong with you? You got to make a move. You gotta shift it to gear. You gotta buckle down and give it a whirl. The scene is set right out of the book with the sunset. And a beautiful girl, so you got to, got to. Come on, girls. You gotta make a move. Come on.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, baby. gotta make a move, come on.
You gotta make a move,
you gotta make a move, come on.
Oh, my bad. I just got caught up in the magic of the night. The fireflies, the beautiful sunset.
Sunset? Sunset? Oh, my goodness. It's getting late. You know, I better get inside.
What?
Wait a minute. I see what's going on here. You afraid of the dark, aren't you?
Yes, that's it. I am terrified. You know, I better get inside.
Hold on. Wait a minute. You know, don't worry. I used to be afraid of the dark, too. Wait a minute, I'm still afraid of the dark.
I'm sorry, I have to go.
All right.
Good night.
Good night.
No, sir, I did not come all this way. Putting up with your body odor so you can let her walk away like this.
What are you talking about?
Look, I'm an animal. And I got instincts. And you two are obviously digging on each other.
Oh, you're crazy. I'm just bringing her to Farquaad.
Uh-huh. So you don't got no feelings for her at all?
Look, even if I did, which I'm not saying I do, because I don't. Mm-hmm. She's a princess and I'm...
An ogre?
Yeah, an ogre. Mm-hmm. Where are you going?
I'm going to get my wood before your fire dies.
Princess Fiona, Princess, where you at? Ooh, I ain't playing no games. This place is good.
What you do with the princess?
Donkey, I am the princess. It's me in this body.
Ooh, you done ate the princess.
Princess, can you hear me? I get you out of there.
Donkey!
What in the world done happened to you?
By day one way, by night another. This shall be the norm until you find true love's first kiss and then take love's true form.
Oh, this just beautiful. I didn't know you wrote poetry, girl.
It's a curse. I've had it since I was a girl.
A curse?
A witch cast a spell on me. And so now every night when the sun comes down, I turn into this hideous, ugly beast.
Oh, calm down. You ain't that ugly. Okay, I ain't gonna lie. You are ugly, but your ugly is just at nighttime. Shrek's ugly is 24/7. Wait a minute. This is just perfect.
Perfect? Donkey Lord Farquaad finds out I look like this, he'll never marry me.
So,
I have to marry my true love. The kiss is the only thing that will break the spell and make me beautiful.
But you know, you and Shrek, well, let's just say you got a lot in common.
Shrek?
Yeah, I mean, if he knew all of this, maybe y'all could...
No, Donkey! He can't know, and you can't tell him not a word. Promise you won't tell. Promise!
Okay, calm down. I won't tell him. But, you should. Man, I know when this is over, I'm gonna need some serious therapy.
Hey, Princess. Ooh. How's it going, first of all? Good. Oh, good for me too. Thanks. I'm okay. I picked this flower right over there is where it grew. And I don't really, but it made me think of you because it's pretty is what I'm trying to say. And you are also pretty. But I like you anyway. So please accept this flower with its petals and a stem, which represent my feelings and tells you how. Oh man, I'm in trouble. When words fail, what will I do? When words fail, how will she know how I feel? When words fail, will I fail too? Hello, fair princess. Oh, look, the moon is out tonight. You remind me of that moon because it's big and bright. But by big, I don't mean chubby. Obviously, you're not fat, but your personality is biggish, which is what I meant by that. Sorry about that fat thing. I'm on the hefty side myself. I like to blame the gene pool, which reminds me of... Oh man, where am I going with this? When words fail, what will I do? When words fail, how will she know how I feel? When words fail, will I fail too? Do I have a snowball's chance? Are my prospects just too grim? I've spent my life stuck in the mud. Now I'm crawling out on a limb. If words fail, she'll know what I mean. If words fail, she'll just take my hand. She'll see me like no one else has. If words fail, she'll understand. She'll understand.
I can't think about Shrek. Not now. I'm a princess after all. And look at me. I mean, really, who could ever love a beast so hideous and ugly? That's why I can't stay here with Shrek. My only chance to live happily ever after is to marry my one true love. Good morning, dawn. Good morning, day. Good morning, morning, dove. I had a long and sleepless night pondering true love. My fairy tale I know so well has somehow gone awry. Looks can be deceiving, but feelings cannot lie. Do I love him? Last night I was uncertain, but this morning, Shrek, thank goodness, there's something I have to tell you.
That's fine. I heard you talk enough last night.
Oh, you heard what I said?
Yeah, every word. Especially who could love such a hideous beast.
But I thought that wouldn't matter to you.
Yeah, well, it does. Ah, right on time. Princess, I brought a little present for you.
Fiona, 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 Fiona. Princess Fiona.
As promised. Now about my swap.
Cleared off as agreed, and the deed has been put in your name. Now step away before I change my mind. Forgive me, Princess, for startling you. I am Lord Farquaad.
Forgive me, Lord Farquaad, for I was just saying a short farewell.
Oh, that is too sweet. But you don't have to waste your good manners on the ogre. It's not like it has feelings.
No, you're right. It doesn't.
Princess Fiona, beautiful, fair, flawless Fiona. I ask your hand in marriage. Will you be the perfect bride for the perfect groom?
Lord Farquaad, I accept. Nothing would
excellent! I shall start the plans for tomorrow. We wed.
No! I mean, why wait? Let's get married today, before sunset.
Ooh, anxious, aren't we? Captain, right ahead, tell him it's code red. You're right, the sooner the better. There's so much to do. We'll be married by sunset.
Ooh, there's nothing like a good night's sleep. What a mess.
Fare thee well, ogre.
Shrek, what is you doing? You letting her get away. Man, look, there's something I gotta tell you. We talked last night and well.
Yeah, I know. I heard the two of you talking. Y'all two are such great friends, aren't you? Why don't you follow her home?
But Shrek, I wanted to go home with you.
I live alone. Me and my swamp, no one else.
But I thought we were...
Yeah! What do you thought wrong? So you know what? I'm just gonna build a 10-foot wall around all my land and shut the whole world out.
Life can't get any worse. You get evicted from a swamp.
I really thought that ogre was gonna help us.
He still might. Maybe if we close our eyes,
we'll find
really hard.
Ogre!
You look beyond their heads.
You're 34 and you need a shave. What? Am I wrong?
Where to now?
40 miles north, they said. There's a landfill with our names on it.
Landfill? What's next? A dug hill?
Creatures do. We wait for miracles. We wish upon stars. Why, my cricket always told
me. Oh, shut up. If that cricket knew any better, he would have seen that windshield coming.
No, we just need to lay low until all of this blows over.
Lay low? We have laid low for too long.
No, none of this would have happened if I was a real boy. Why can't I be a real boy?
Listen up, puppet. We spend our whole lives wishing we weren't so freaking strange. They made us feel that way, but it's they who need to change.
The way they think, that is.
That's right, Papa.
It's time we stop the hiding. It's time we stand up tall, say, hey world, I'm different. And here I am, splinters and all. Splinters and oh!
Let your freak flag wave. Let your freak flag fly. Never take it down, never take it down. Raise it way.
It's hard to be a puppet. So many string attacks.
But it's not the choice you made. Just how you were hatched.
Let your freak flag wave. Let your freak flag fly. Never take it down. Never take it down. Raise it way up high. Let your freak flag fly.
I'm a scientologist!
Scientologist!
I did time in jail.
Yeah, yeah!
Time
to punch
and
down.
We don't
judge! Let your freak flag wave! Let your freak flag fly! it down. Raise it way up.
What are you doing?
I think you of all people will recognize the wall when you see one.
Yeah, well, the wall's supposed to go around my swamp, not through it.
And it is going around your swamp, see? That's your half, this is my half.
Your half?
Yes, my half. I helped rescue the princess, didn't I? I did half the work, I get half the booty.
Back off.
Nope, you back off.
Stubborn jackass.
Smelly ogre.
This is my swamp.
There you go. My. Me. Well, guess what? Now it's my turn, so you just shut up and pay attention. You are mean to me, you insult me, and you never appreciate anything I do. You always pushing me around or pushing me away. You so wrapped up in layers, onion boy. You afraid of your own feelings.
If I treated you so badly, why did you come back?
Because that's what friends do. They forgive each other.
Oh, go away.
There you go again, just like you did Princess Fiona. All she ever did was like you, maybe even love you.
Love me? She called me a hideous beast. I heard the two of you talking.
She wasn't talking about you. She was talking about her... somebody else.
She wasn't talking about me. Well, who was she talking about?
I ain't saying nothing. Mm-mm. You don't want to listen to me, right? Right?
Donkey!
Mm-mm. Nope.
All right, I'm sorry, okay? All right, I'm sorry. I guess I am just a big, stupid, ugly ogre. Can you forgive me?
Hey, that's what friends do, right?
Right. Friends.
Friends!
Okay. So, what did the princess say about me?
What you asking me for? Why don't you just go and ask her?
Ask her?
You want to be a hero? Now's your chance.
Donkey, the wedding will never make it in time.
Now what kind of noble steed would I be if I ain't have a plan? Come on, follow me.
Sorry, can we just skip to the I do's?
Go on.
Well then, do you, Lord Farquaad, take Princess Fiona?
I do.
And do you?
I do.
Well, I thought you might. By the power vested in me, I now pronounce you king.
Stop the wedding!
Shrek?
What is he doing here? I mean, really, it's rude enough showing up uninvited to a wedding?
Fiona, I have to talk to you.
Oh, now you want to talk? Well, it's a little late for that. So, like, if you'll excuse me...
But you can't marry him.
And why not?
Because he's only marrying you so he can be king.
This is outrageous, Fiona. Don't listen to him, my darling.
He's not your true love.
And what do you know about true love?
Well, I...
Oh, this is precious. The ogre has fallen in love with a princess. Guards, take this abomination out of my sight.
No! Let's hear what the monster has to say. It might be worth the laugh.
Oh, you were awful. You heard her, ogre. Express yourself with as few grunts as possible.
All right. It's a big, bright, beautiful world with happiness all around. It's peaches and cream if our dream comes true. It's a big, bright, beautiful world with possibilities everywhere. If true love is blind, maybe you won't mind the view. I know I'm not the handsome prince for whom you've waited. I don't have a fancy castle and I'm not sophisticated. A princess and an ogre, I admit, is complicated. You never read a book like this, but fairy tales should really be updated. It's a big, bright, beautiful world. I see it now, I'll let it in. I'll tear down a wall and build a spot for two to be with you.
Fiona, are we ready, my darling?
I can't.
Stop the wedding!
Stop him! What are you freaks doing interrupting my wedding?
Freaks, huh? I guess it takes one to know.
What?
Be prepared to have your mind blown!
Daddy?
I assume my invitation was lost in the mail.
Well, maybe if you hadn't abandoned me in the woods.
Abandoned you? You're 27 living in my basement.
People of Duwak, your leader is a halfling!
Which is a lovely thing.
Man, I'm a giant man. I have a kingdom. I'm not a freak. I have a castle.
Bring in the lanterns.
Stop the wedding.
Fiona?
I wanted to show you before.
Well, I guess this explains a lot.
Oh, this is disgusting. Guards. All this hocus pocus alters nothing. This wedding is binding and that makes me king. See? See? As for you, my wife, I'll have you locked in the tower for the rest of your days.
Oh, no, you won't.
It was my girl that did that. All hail the dragon. I love you, baby.
So, you were saying?
Fiona, I'm your true love.
Yeah, I know. And I'm yours. I don't understand. I'm supposed to be beautiful.
But Fiona, you are beautiful. Once upon a time, to look like us would be a pity. But now we know that beautiful ain't always pretty.
It by the book. Now I know that's not my story. You take me as I am, love me as I look, standing here in all my glory. I am sweetness, I am bratty, I'm a princess, I'm a fatty, I'm a mess of contradictions in a dress. I am sassy, I am sappy, when I'm with you I am happy. This is my story.
You laugh at all my jokes, even though they're crude. You don't mind that I'm not classy.
We make a perfect pair, radiant and rude, so in love and much too gassy. We are ogres, we are scary, we are donkeys, we are hairy. We have bold and brand new stories to be told. We will write them, we will tell them, you will hear them, you will smell them. This is our story.
And so, the little ogre found a perfect swamp and lived with a beautiful princess.
And his best friend.
And his best friend.
And the gingerbread man.
And a very handsome
puppy. Okay.
And a cross-dressing wolf.
What makes us special? Ooh.
What makes us special makes us
strong. We are witches, we are fairies, we are weirdos.
I'm fairies.
We are giant pots of chocolate in a jar. We are puppets, we are rabbits, we are hobbits with bad habits. We're all screwy, but delighted, crazy stew. We are different and united. You are us and we are you. This is our story. This is our story.
Thank you.